Hello everyone. People keep asking me, how do I edit my videos? Well, I keep saying that there's going to be tons of better, videos that shows you how to use the tools in the Cyberlink Powerdirector 8 editor here better than I possibly could, but I'll just try and keep it brief to give you a general idea on how I edit my videos. I have a gaming track, which is the game video like that, and I have the voice track, which is just me pointing the camera away from me just to record my video like that. So what I first do is I put the voice track into the timeline like that, then I right click and then click split audio. And then it'll do a little confirmation, it'll insert the audio, so click OK. Then the audio will go here. This is completely mute now. You don't need this video. So now I'll put the gaming track in there like that, and now you've got the gaming footage. Yeah, I record them both separately, as I've said before, just thought I would re-mention that in this video. And then what I'm going to do here is click on the game video and click Power Tools, Video Crop, Crop Video. Because what I want to do is get the black borders off the edge of the video, so I'm just going to do that. I'm going to skip to the next keyframe and duplicate it, so that means the whole video will be black borderless. Just like that, and see, it crops it right in that video. Now the next thing that I have to do is sync this together. Now what I do to do this is listen to this. Listen carefully. Oh, wait. Actually, the next thing I should do is balance the audio. Excuse me. So click on this little audio mixing room button here. And in my case, this is completely different depending on which video I make or which game video I make. But I always put the voice at 100 because I need to boost the volume of my voice. And then the game video track I have to tweak depending on which video I'm making. In this case, for Mario Sunshine, between like somewhere around 10 to 8 is good for my Mario Sunshine. And always make sure that this bar here on the timeline is all the way to the left when you do that, so it'll automatically adjust the whole video track at the same time, rather than watch us like making a point in the video. See that on the thingy down here? Yeah, see that? You don't want that, so press Control Z to cancel if you ever have to do that. Now, listen to this thing that I do on my voice track. You hear that? That's me pressing a button very hard next to the camera to indicate that I'm doing something on screen. In this case, it's unpausing the game. Now, watch what happens on the video up here. See that? You can tell that they're off sync. However, I can sync them up just by that sound alone. So what I'm going to do is click the voice track here, and behind that mark, see down here, I'm going to split it like that, and then right-click, remove. That'll make it easier for me to sync this up, and then I'm going to drag that audio track over to near where the pause was on this timeline here. So let's just do that and listen. The click is a little bit ahead of time, so I gotta move it. That actually sounded just right there. Okay, now what I do here is I cut off the rest of this like this. I just highlight the whole sucker like that by dragging these little yellow arrows, and then click cut. And then the whole thing goes. This is for the blue coin side, may I add. And then I go all the way to the end of this. Yeah, you can resize this timeline just by dragging the numbers left and right like that. And then what I do here is I go to the very end of it and cut out the rest that I don't need using that same yellow arrow trick here. And that's just the start of it. And then what I do here is I go to produce, whatever you want to call it. I was talking like produce, like a grocery store for some reason. Then I click on the .wmv video thing here. That's Windows Media Video. And then I select Zoom High Quality, which will be 640 by 480. And then I start processing the video like that. Now, I have to wait for it to process before I can do any further editing like that. This is going to take about 39 minutes. I already did this before off camera, so I don't really have to show this. But this took about 39 minutes to do so. So I'm not going to show that. So I'm going to cancel the rendering, and I'm going to move over to the making of the blue coin boxes. Okay, so now you've got your video here. This is the complete video that you just made with the blue coins thing, but it's completely boxless whenever I collect blue coins. So now I'm gonna have to start making them. Now you notice that the first one that I collect in here is this one right here at the side of the building. See that?
Yep, it transforms into a blue.
Yeah, that's the video that I still have to edit. Now I have to make a blue box for each, or blue coin box for each of these coins. How do I do it? Let's begin. Okay, so what do I first do with my blue coin boxes? The first thing that I do is look up the coin in my guide here. I got a official Nintendo Power Player's Guide blah 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 thingy. Well, there's always 2 pages of blue coin coverage here. And you notice that it shows everything, including the episode number and stuff like that, that you can find the coin in. So then I have to match that up to my box. So the first coin that I got was the one next to that building way at the start, so it's not showing on this map. I think it's this one right here, number 2. See that? It's a M right against the building there. And then you look on here to check the episode numbers, and then it says scribbled M on the wall, episodes 1 through 8, and then I got to write that up in the box. If you guessed that I would be using my all-powerful GIMP tool, yep, that's how I do it. Now, I've got this right here. I've got a blue coin box here in my video resources. It looks something like this. There's 2 layers to this box here. You'll notice that this part is transparent, but it's actually on a separate layer than the numbers. Watch this. See this? The numbers are on their own layer like that, and that's how I am able to edit each of these boxes individually. Now, you'll notice that, as I said, that I have to put those numbers, it was in all the episodes for that first coin, so I would just leave it at that. But in the case of other episodes, what I would have to do is actually take my eraser tool, and let's say it was only available in 2 through 8, so I would go ahead and erase that number 1 like that, and then I would type something in this box. To type in that box, I would go to my text tool. I want white text, and I'm going to select the sans bold text. I'm going to drag a box inside that box, and then I would type whatever I need inside that box, and then I would save it as is to enter into that video. This basically is added into it as another video layer. I'm going to show you that when I get back to my video editor. All right, now I'm back in the video editor. Let's say that this image that I made, the PNG image, is the image that I wanted to use. So, you know, I don't have any text in it right now. I'm just making this as a quick video here. Well, as you see on the video, that's about the time when I'm going to collect the coin. So I would drag that onto pip track number 1, and then it'll appear into the video. This top track here is considered to be the lowest one. Then you go pip track 1, 2, 3, etc., and they each go higher up, and that indicates which layer is on top of the other. So I'm going to resize this box to put in the corner like that, and you've got your box into the video. Now, then I would go over to the next coin in the video, which is this over here, and then I would make another box for it. See this other M at the top of the building, and then I might cut through the video, like if I have to, depending on, like, you'll notice that there's no audio at this point in the track here, because I had to leave the area to change episodes at this point. So I will be cutting through this. You know, I'll have to cut this out of the track. And so that's basically how I do my blue coin videos. As you can tell, this takes a lot of time and a lot of work, which is why I don't like doing it, but you kind of have to do it with Super Mario Sunshine. So I'm just gonna end it off here and start on the 100 coin shine. Alright, the 100 coin shine is done exactly the same way. I sped this up just by syncing these suckers back together. Cutting these things ahead of time and can sync them. Just imagine that I already synced them ahead of time. Well, now I've got this new box here. Yeah, I have a box for pretty much anything here. I've also got a box for just typing stuff into, like a completely blank box like that. I've got a box for the 100 coins that'll tell you, that I'll put in the video, that'll say how long. Yes, I did all this stuff custom for the videos. Like, it took me 13 minutes and 34 seconds to make that, the 100 coin video and stuff like that, and it's basically done the exact same way. And if I ever want to merge two points of a video together, like smoothly, without like having a jump cut or something, like I'm just gonna split some of the stuff up here. I already did this ahead of time so I can experiment with this. So let's imagine that I wanted to join this stuff together like that. Now, I want to merge both my voice and the game audio at the exact same time. So I'm not gonna be able to do that under the current settings. So I have to click this button at the upper left corner, click that edit, then go to preferences, then go to editing, and then click link all tracks when moving or removing content. So that'll basically sync all the tracks together. This reminds me, I should also mention something about the voice track. When I split the audio away from that useless video track and, you know, just use the audio, I have to have that box unchecked. Otherwise, I'll remove both the video and the audio at the same time. That's key to it. Anyway, if I want to merge two clips together smoothly, I have to go to the transition room, and I have my favorites here. I have them all set together, and then drag your favorite one or whichever one you want over to the track like that, and then play your video like this. If you want to play the whole thing at once, you have to click the movie button on the movie mode here. Remember that. So now I'll click the play button and see how it merges together.
Hey. I just got here. You can see them for all.
See how that works? So you gotta make sure that you leave a little bit of leeway between audio tracks, otherwise they'll merge together or just cut out. It takes a little practice to get, but you'll get the hang of it once you try it yourself. And then after I process this video through producing it, then what happens is that I put it together with the blue coin one, and then merge it together with one of those transitions, and then the video's finished. Yes, this takes hours to do. Here's what one looks like. I'm going to go to the Super Mario Sunshine finished ones. I forgot which one of these it is, actually. Let me just take a look-see through here. I'm pretty sure I did the 100 coin one like two episodes ago. Let me check this one here. Is this the one that I... Yeah, this is the one that I did the blue coins with. Blue coins and 100 coins with. And then you get something that looks like this. Just see there how the boxes popped up like that? That'll be how it looks on the video. Now, you can also extend the duration of those boxes. Like, if you go back to the editing and let's put a box in there just for the fun of it, wherever you want to. You can also extend the duration of it just by dragging on the timeline of how long you want that box to be. I have it set default at 4.5 seconds or something like that. I forgot, so that it automatically puts it at the correct duration every time. I've also got boxes for, yeah, more boxes. The menu button boxes, you know, like at the end of a part, I have the level select and mission select buttons. Yeah, I put those at the end of a part. It's all really simple and all done in layers. It's just really, really time consuming and a lot of micromanaging. But once you play around with the Power Director, you'll understand what I mean on how to do this stuff. And I hope this helps you a little bit. And I'll see you later. Enjoy making videos.